Hi all. Today in this video, I am going to explain the various looping statements used in C programming language. We all know that C is the most commonly used structured programming language. In structured programming language, all the statements are executed in a sequential manner. But in some situations, we have to execute some statements repeatedly or continuously based on some condition. The set of statements which has to be executed repeatedly or continuously is known as a loop or an iteration. For every looping statement, we have to check the condition. The condition is evaluated, and if the condition is true, then the body of the loop will be executed. And if the condition is false, then the loop will be terminated. Normally, every looping statement has three parts. The first part is the initialization. Initialization means we have to set the starting value of the variable. Or we can say that we have to set the looping counter. For example, a equal to 1, I equal to 1, b equal to 0, etc. The second part is the condition. That is, we have to check whether or up to what time the set of statements or the body of the loop has to be executed. The second part is the condition, that is, we have to ensure up to what time the loop has to be executed. Normally, the condition can be applied in C programming language with the help of various relational operators. The third part is increment or decrement. That is, we have to either increment the looping variable or we have to decrement the looping variable. So these are the basic three steps required for any kind of looping. The various looping statements used in C programming language includes the while loop, do while loop and the for loop. While loop. The syntax for the while loop is while, condition, body of the loop. First, the condition is evaluated, and if the condition is true, the body of the loop will be executed. And if the condition is false, the loop will be terminated and the control is transferred to the next statement after the loop. As I said earlier, for every looping statement, we have three steps, that is initialization, condition and increment or decrement. That is, we have to initialize the value of the variable, and then we have to check the condition, and if the condition is true, the body of the loop will be executed. And after that, it will either increment or decrement the value, and again the condition will be evaluated. And if the condition is true, then again the body of the loop will be executed. So this process continues until the condition becomes true. And the main thing is that the while loop is an entry control loop because the condition is evaluated at the starting of the loop. If the condition is true, then only the body of the loop will be executed. Let's take an example for printing the first natural numbers using while loop. Here, the variable I, and I am initializing the variable I equal to 1, and the condition while I less than or equal to 5, and then the body of the loop, that is here I am printing the value of the variable I and increment the loop counter. In this case, in the first iteration, initially the value of the I will be 1 and condition I less than or equal to 5, that is 1 less than or equal to 5, condition is true and the value 1 will be printed. In the second iteration, after that, the I will be incremented and the value of I becomes 2, and 2 less than or equal to 5, condition is true and 2 will be printed. Again, it will be incremented. Now I becomes 3, 3 less than or equal to 5, condition is true and 3 will be printed. And again, iteration 4, the value is incremented, I becomes 5, 4, 4 less than or equal to 5 and 4 will be printed. And again, incremented, I becomes 5, 5 less than or equal to 5, and now 5 will be printed. And after that, the value of I is incremented, then I become 6. So 6 greater than, sorry, 6 less than or equal to 5. Now the condition is false. So the loop will be terminated. And we will get the output 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. The next looping statement which is used in C is do while loop. The syntax is do, body of the loop and the condition. In this case, the body of the loop will be executed and after that the condition is evaluated. In this diagram, it is clearly mentioned that initially we have to initialize the variable and then body of the loop will be executed and increment or decrement. After that, the condition is evaluated. If the condition is true, then again the body of the loop will be executed. And this process continues up to the condition becomes true. And do while loop is an exit control loop because the condition is evaluated at the bottom of the loop. So, whatever may be the condition, that is the condition becomes true or false, for the first time the body of the loop will be executed. That is minimum, at least one time the body of the loop will be executed in the case of do while loop. That's why do while is known as exit control loop. I'm taking the same example. That is here I equal to 1 initialization and increment or incrementing the loop. After that, testing the condition and after executing the loop, we will get the output 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, in the case of do while loop, the condition will be evaluated at the bottom of the bottom of the loop. The third looping statement used in C programming language is the for loop. So, for a looping statement, we have three parts. That is, we have to initialize the variable, we have to check the condition, and we have to increment or decrement the value of the counter. So, in the case of do while and while loop, we are performing all the three steps in a sequential manner. But in the case of for loop, all the three parts are included in a single line. We can see that initialization, condition, increment or decrement, and then the body of the loop. Here, first we have to initialize the value of the variable, then we have to check the condition, and if the condition is true, body of the loop will be executed. And again, the value will be incremented or decremented. Again, it checks the condition, and if the condition is true, the body of the loop will be executed. And this process continues until the condition becomes true. And for loop is also an entry control loop because the condition is evaluated at the starting. That is, before executing the body of the loop, the condition needs to be evaluated. And if the condition is true, then only the body of the loop will be executed. Here, I am taking the same example for printing the natural numbers. Here, in the case of for loop, all the three steps, that is initialization, condition and increment or decrement, all are included in a single line. And we are executing this program, we will get the result 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, looping is very important in any programming language because with the help of looping statements, we can reduce the length of the code. For example, if you have to print a message, hello world, 100 times, then we can print with the help of printf statement. That is, we have to write the printf statements 100 times. But if you are using the looping statements, then we can print the same message 100 or 1000 times with a 3 to 4 lines of code. So, with the help of looping statements, we can reduce the overall length of the program. Depends on the need of the user can select any one of the looping statements. Thank you.